Meeting of the House Tourism and Economic and Recreational Development Committee to order. Dan, would you please take the roll?
Representative Daly?
Present.
Representative Bellman? Representative Brennan?
Designation.
Representative Sepita Freites?
Here.
Representative Serrato?
Here.
Representative Cerisi?
On designation.
Representative Krajewski?
Here.
Representative O'Mara?
On designation.
Representative Powell?
Here.
Representative Probst? Representative Prokopiak?
On designation.
Representative Sappi?
Designation.
Representative Tackett?
Correction. Representative Sappi is on, she's participating virtually.
All right.
And I heard...
Tackett.
Oh, designation for Tackett.
Okay. Representative Young? Representative Oberlander?
Here.
Representative Armenini? Representative Barton? Representative Cook?
Designation.
Representative Flick? Representative Hogan?
Designation.
Representative Jones?
Designation.
Representative Rader?
Designation.
Representative Smith? Representative Twardzik?
Designation.
Representative Wentling?
Designation.
Okay.
A quorum is present.
Thank you. So is there a motion to consider House Resolution 327? Representative. We have a motion. No. Serrato. We have a motion by Representative Serrato and a second by Representative Barton. All righty. Josh, would you please explain the resolution?
House Resolution 327 recognizes March 8th, 2024 as International Women's Day in Pennsylvania.
Thank you. Representative Marcel, would you like to come up and say a few words? Thank you.
Thank you very much for having me today, and thank you to the chairs for considering this important resolution. International Women's Day is a global observance that celebrates the remarkable achievements of women in various fields, be it social, economic, cultural, or political. 7 years ago, the Fearless Girl statue debuted in downtown Manhattan across from the famous Charging Bull statue, ahead of International Women's Day. The plaque below the statue stated, "Know the power of women in leadership. She makes a difference." I had the opportunity to visit the statue with my daughter years ago, and now this day reminds me of the work still needed to ensure every woman and girl can achieve her full potential. In Pennsylvania, we have a proud tradition of women's leadership. From the first female Speaker of the House and President Pro Tem of the Senate to groundbreaking figures in science, arts, and civil rights, our state has been shaped by the tenacity and vision of women. My resolution today acknowledges not only these historical figures, but also the countless women whose daily efforts strengthen our communities and enrich our lives. International Women's Day encourages us to reflect on our advancements, call for change, and celebrate the courage and determination of women who have played an extraordinary role in the history of our state and our world. As we consider this resolution, let us unite together in support of women's achievements and continue to foster an environment where every woman can lead with confidence. I urge my colleagues to please support this resolution, and I wanted to thank Representative Lindsey Pell for co-priming this resolution with me. It means a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative. Is there any further discussion? Senator Pell.
Thank you so much, Chairwoman.
thank you so much as well to my colleague, Representative Marcel, for allowing me to co-prime this resolution with her. As said, International Women's Day is not just a celebration of the contributions that women have made, not just to the state, but across the world, but it's also a recognition of the challenges and how far we do still need to go when it comes to ensuring that women are paid an equal wage, when it comes to ensuring that women have access to education, when it comes to ensuring that women can be safe in the workplace as well as at home. We have a duty and a responsibility to ensure that we are consistently fighting for women in all of our spaces. And so I'm so grateful for Representative Marcel and others for supporting this resolution and hope to see its passage. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else? Chair Oberlinder, would you like to say a few words?
Well, as a woman leader, how could I not say something about this resolution? Thank you to both the sponsor and both the prime sponsors. And as a woman leader, a daughter, a granddaughter, and a mother, all of strong women, I congratulate you on this resolution and look forward to continuing to make a difference in the world for all individuals and especially women. Thank you.
And I would like to just round that all out by, I really appreciate that you both brought this resolution and that it was assigned to this committee. I can't think of a better way to start the week and end the month. We're almost through with this month, which is tough, but I agree with everything that my colleagues said. It's incredibly important to recognize this, and I'm delighted that it's international. I feel like we're in good company. And I think that the rights of women are being challenged in so many ways, and we still have a long way to go. So it's really great to see so many women in the audience out there. So thank you all for being here. I'm not sure why you're all here, but whatever it is, we're happy to see you. And it's really been great to work with a co-chair from the other party, the other side of the aisle. We get along really well. It's been, you know, so I feel really good, and I thank you for getting us off to a good start today and, you know, the rest of the year. Thank you. Oh. We can call the roll, or does anyone have any objection? Seeing no objection, the resolution passes unanimously. So thank you so much for bringing it to us. So I'll say formally, hearing no objections, House Resolution 327 is reported from the House Tourism and Economic and Recreational Development Committee. All righty, so we're gonna move on to the next piece of legislation, what's the number? Oh, 331, sorry. Is there a motion to consider House Resolution 331? Representative Young? Thank you. Is there a second? Representative Fink? Thank you. Josh, would you please explain the resolution?
House Resolution 331 designates April 9th, 2024, as Paul Robeson Day in Pennsylvania.
Great. Representative Krajewski, would you like to say a few words on your resolution? And you can come down and address us.
Oh, okay.
If you'd like. It's a little different. But we can all see you.
Good morning. Good morning to the committee. Thank you so much for your consideration of House Resolution 331. I'm very excited to be able to bring this resolution to the committee, recognizing the birthday of Paul Robeson on April 9th as Paul Robeson Day. We're really grateful here in Pennsylvania for to have had such a leader as Paul Robeson to have his final years in the state of Philadelphia, in the state of Pennsylvania, and also in the city of Philadelphia. Paul Robeson not only was an extremely talented athlete, actor, and singer, He was also an extremely important leader in the struggles of workers, civil rights activists, and just oppressed people all throughout the United States and also the international community. In the 1920s, 30s, and 40s, he rallied with workers throughout the South and throughout the United States, advocating for civil rights, advocating for better wages for workers. He was a leader in the civil rights movement around anti-lynching campaigns, making sure that all oppressed communities were given equal rights and equal dignities. And he was a true leader in that fight for the vast majority of his professional life. And during the last few years of his life, I am grateful to be able to say that he spent his final days in West Philadelphia at the Paul Robeson House and Museum, which is located in the 180th District, which is my district. And I live a few blocks away from that house. I walk by it probably once a week, and his family are still stewards of that home. It is a museum, not only as a legacy and a testament to his work and the work that he did throughout his life, but also is a testament to the importance of civil rights, of community empowerment. And so whenever I walk by that house, I'm filled with purpose, I'm filled with his leadership, and it felt only right to be able to introduce this resolution to honor his legacy and to honor the community that he's built in Philadelphia. So that's it. That's the resolution. Recognizing a leader in civil rights in this state, in this country, and in this world. And I thank you for your support or your consideration of House Resolution 331. Thank you.
Thank you for bringing this forward. So on the resolution, is there any discussion? Sure.
Rep, thank you so much for bringing this. As a father of, especially as a father of a very diverse family, as you know, I would just add a couple comments. He was also valedictorian, Mr. Robinson, something I was not. He was a lawyer, thankfully, something I'm not. Or a singer, I'm definitely not, if anybody wants to hear me. And an activist and an athlete. So I had never heard of the gentleman. So it's very important that these folks are brought up. Not just for diversity, but for everybody. So I think sometimes we almost make light of some resolutions, but these are so critical. So I just want to say thank you for bringing this to everybody's attention.
Thank you, Representative Fink. Is there anyone else? Madam Chair, do you have any comments? Okay. I would just like to say thank you for bringing this up. Feel like I recognize that name, and I think it's really nice. Thank you for both of you for bringing to light all of the different things you did. So appreciate that. With no further discussion, we can call the roll, but I'm also going to ask if there are any negative votes on the resolution. Okay. Hearing none, House Resolution 331 is reported from the House Tourism and Economic and Recreational Development Committee.
Thank you.
Thank you. And that is it for legislation for this committee. I appreciate all of you being here. I know it was a little early, but we have a long day ahead of us. So thank you so much. Get these out to the floor.